screen time have so many harmful effects such as headache, poor vision, irregular sleep cycle, reduced in physical activities, which in further leads to overweight or have health problems later in life. Most of the baby's brain development happens in the first 2 years of life. Therefore, it is very important for babies and toddlers to explore their environment and experience many sights, sounds, tastes, and textures. But in today's world, it can be very hard to keep babies and toddlers away from all the TVs, tablets, computers, smartphones, and gaming systems. Hello, mommies and daddies, welcome back to my channel Mom and Baby. Before we get actually started, I would like to thank you to all of you for your love and support in terms of your like, comment, subscribe, and share. This means a lot to us. Thank you so much once again. If you are new here, you are most welcome. My name is Sarita and I am a mother of 20-month-old adorable baby girl. I normally prepare video on child care, mother care, and family care in general. So please give your love by hitting the like button and subscribing our channel. And also please hit the bell icon for our regular updates. Let's become a big family soon. In this video, I'm going to share with you top 10 tips on how to keep your toddler and kid away from watching TV or using smartphones. So without further ado, let's get started. Take your children for outdoor games or spend time for games. There is a proverb of saying, healthy mind stays in healthy body, which is very true. Games or sports like skating, basketball, football, swimming, and others are one of the easiest ways to keep children away from the screen. This sort of activities provides mental and physical stimulation, which will help to enhance the key skills such as build motor skills, strengthen bones and muscles, boost the immune system, and so on. This way, child will completely forget about TV and phones. Therefore, try to spend at least an hour or so as an outdoor game, or you can even go for a walk. My next tip is encourage your child in household activities or chores. Children love to do whatever you are doing and are very smart in copying the things. So try to encourage your child to participate in household activities. If I am cleaning my house, I normally give my baby some wipes or small cloth to clean. If I am cooking, I let my child put all the cut pieces in one bowl, and so on. This helps in teaching about cleanliness, disciplines, time management, and most importantly, how to look after yourself. This way, we can spend more time with your child and build a strong bonding relationship and keeps our child away from the screen. Therefore, it's a win-win situation. You can even ask your child to tidy up the toys or whatever your child is playing after the playtime. My another tip is be a role model and mind your own screen time, meaning set a good example. If you want your child not to use screen, then you have to restrict your own screen time. Children always try to copy the behavior of their parents. If they see you reading a book, they are more likely to read. And if they see you watching television, they will do the same. Therefore, try to not to use screen at least for a certain period of time in a day or whenever you are spending quality time with your baby. You can even make a schedule. For example, if you are putting up screen restriction from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., make sure you can avoid all the screen works during that time. If you have anything to do, then try to finish either before or after the time Or if this seems absolutely impossible, sometime in our life we can get it, then make sure to use the screen in a different room or away from your child's eye. In addition to this, try to keep your mobile phone on vibration or silent so that if anybody calls, your child is not distracted. I normally keep my mobile phone on silent so that I can give my full concentration on my baby while I am with her. If I have to make any phone calls, I try to make it when my baby is not around. I know it may sound odd or it sounds difficult, but it's a good for your child. You can let your friends, family, relatives or colleague or anyone. And of course, this is the betterment of our child. And they will understand it, trust me. Our children follow us. Hence, if we decrease the use of screen in front of our kids, their use will also decrease. Therefore, set a good example because children learn from parents. My next tips is spend quality family time. Spending quality family time is the best thing to do, which helps to overall development of a family as a whole. Set a time for family, for example, for 2 hours, and the entire family are not allowed to use any sort of screens. Instead, you can spend time together, such as going out for a walk or short trips or picnic, playing some indoor games like carrom board, chess, etc. This sort of games will help to build different skills such as coordination, cognitive development, decision making, and so on. It will be good idea if the whole family is together at the dining table at least once in a day. This will also give an opportunity to communicate with each other and help your child to share the things with you. If you don't spend more time together, your kids are more likely to look for a sort of companionship in the gadget. So try to spend or invest some more time with your child, as your child will grow really fast, and when they grow up, you will be glad that you did it. This ensures quality time and teaches your child the importance of family and the togetherness. So always try to spare or spend some quality time with your family. Try to make it as a habit so that your family will get used to with it, and then you will be able to spend quality time with the family. My next tips is encourage hobbies. Hobby is one of the best and easiest way to keep children away from screens. So try to identify your child's hobby, which can be anything, such as painting, puzzles, drawing, dancing, reading books, and so on. Try to participate with your child in those activities, as parents' participation stimulates the child's interest immediately and reward them after completing the certain task. Appreciation and rewards are always great motivators for everyone, and they are even more for children. But make sure whenever you are giving any sort of reward to your child, don't give them chocolate or chips, which are not good for the health. Instead, give books or educational things or even praises. Clap your hands, make noises, and so on, so that your child will think, oh, I have done the good thing, so I need to do more of this thing. Therefore, try to encourage your baby as a family. This way, you are building a good habit of your child. Choose the program that have educational element. Screens are everywhere. Therefore, it is very difficult to keep the kids away from TV or screens always. But as a parent, you have a right to choose the program that have an educational videos and rhymes instead of letting your kids to watch cartoons. In this way, your child will learn something as compared to watching cartoons. Also, you and your child can play interactive or color or shape game on the tablet. If you are watching your favorite shows on TV with your child, then this is a bad example of screen time. So, make sure your child's screen time is as productive as possible. Therefore, you can watch rhyme or any sort of educational videos along with your child for minimum of 10 minutes, 15 minutes or so. My next tip is set the schedule. If you are a working parent, your child is likely to watch TV for long hours as compared to stay-home parents. Therefore, even though you are away from home for work or something else, or even if you are working from home, try to make a strict time schedule for your child, and that schedule need to be followed by your entire family. Keep the TV remote control in your hands and don't allow your child to watch TV for more than 1 hour or so in a day in total. Also, help your child to monitor his or her screen so that your child will develop an awareness of time spent. This will help your child to learn to manage screen time as he or she will grow. Remember, the stricter you will become, you have to follow the schedule by your entire family, not only by you. So, if there is a caretaker who is looking after your baby or the grandparents who is looking after the baby, all have to follow the same schedule. Keep TV and computers out of your child's bedroom or place TVs and computers in common place. It is very important to make sure your child's room is gadgets free. This is mainly because the bright blue light emitted by this screen causes delay of melatonin in the body. Melatonin is a hormone that is responsible for inducing sleep. This lack of melatonin disrupts the body's sleep cycle. If you place all the gadgets to the common place, you will be able to implement a strict usage schedule and ensure that your child is exposed to only age-appropriate content. Make gradual changes. If your child spends most of the time watching TV or playing games on your phone, don't ban your child from this in one shot. To start with, try to make a gradual change by cutting down an hour in a week or so. Whenever you are doing this, try to introduce new activities so that your kid spends less time watching TV or engaging with the gadgets without even knowing. Also, give your child 30 minutes to an hour maximum to entertain himself or herself. If it is your child's favorite soap or games, tell your kids it's important to get up, stretch, eat, or play outdoors, especially after sitting and staring at the screen for an hour. Make it a habit, and slowly, slowly, your child will get used to with it, and then you will be able to reduce the screen time of your child. My next tips: turn screen time into your favor. Yes, you can do it. If you want your child to learn or develop a new skill, such as improve their handwriting or eat vegetables or any such desirable action, then make a list of it. Encourage your child to do this sort of activities every day, and if they do, then give them a reward like stars or stickers and so on. And once your child on a certain number of sticker or stars, they can get to use their screen time for a specified time period so that you are in control of the screen time, and in that way you are encouraging your child to do some educational activities rather than spending time on the TV. My golden tips for you all today is the same parenting rules apply to screen time as to anything else. Therefore, set a good example, establish limits, and talk with your child about it, and more importantly, try to spend as much quality time as possible with your family so that your child is not alone and seeking for any sort of companionship with the TV. And if your child is watching TV on her or his phone, try to be engaged with them. Try to interact with them while watching rhyme. It's not necessary that you need to sing rhyme only when your baby is watching it in the TV. You can even sing the rhyme outside, do some action song so that kids will think that, oh, TV time, we can do this sort of thing, not only in front of TV, but anywhere. So try to make a habit of this so that your children is not addicted with the TV or any sort of screen from the first place. I hope you find this video useful. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. And also please let me know in the comment section below how is your experience going on with these tips and tricks. And if you have any other suggestions or if you are doing any sort of tips that has helped your child not to watch the screen time, please let me know in the comment section, because I believe sharing is caring. Until we meet in our next video, take care and bye bye.